scan complete.
Ship production. Pilots Federation alert. The Federal and Imperial Navies have both requested commodities for the construction of new capital ships. President Zachary Hudson has convinced Congress to increase funding for the Federal Navy and to advance the construction program for Farragut-class battle cruisers. In a powerful address, he said, "Defending the Federation is our highest priority in these uncertain times. It is vital that we reinforce our capability to protect the people from all threats. The Federal Navy urgently requires additional resources to meet the new shipbuilding timetable. Deliveries of building fabricators, microbial furnaces and energy grid assemblies are requested at Schweikart City in the Perutis system." A similar declaration was made in the Imperial Senate mere hours later when Senator Denton Patrios announced, "We face adversaries on all sides and from within, eager to corrupt and destroy our proud empire. This is a time to bolster our strength and our resolve." The Imperial Navy confirmed that new Majestic-class interdictors and other military vessels are being assembled. A request has been made for shipments of building fabricators, microbial furnaces and energy grid assemblies to Miyasaka Orbital in the manned system. Alliance consolidates presence in Coalsack Nebula. Pilots Federation alert. the Alliance has opened new starports in the Coalsack Nebula and is offering high prices for Thargoid-related commodities. Following a successful campaign to establish a foothold in the Nebula, the Alliance has announced that several new starports have become operational. These are Betancourt Base in the Muskadark Region PJ-PB61 system, Coal Point in the Coalsack Sector VU-0B66 system, Hanu Arena in the Muskadark Region IMVC-224 system, Burin Port in the Coalsack Sector KNSB-49 system. The starports will serve as launch pads for further exploration of the region. Several corporations are working in partnership with the Alliance to locate commercial and scientific sites of interest. One of the new research stations, Betancourt Base, has requested deliveries of Thargoid commodities. Chief Xenobiologist Dr. Rodian Starthos outlined the offer. The Thargoids have been in the Coalsack Nebula for at least 200 years, giving us an opportunity to increase our understanding of this alien species. Thanks to funding provided by pharmaceutical and bioengineering companies, we can offer generous rewards for shipments of Thargoid biological matter and other artifacts. Core Dynamics bids to purchase Lake...
Earth is scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Of Lacon Spaceways has been made by Core Dynamics, a major shipbuilding corporation in the Federation. The announcement caused ripples in the manufacturing sector, particularly as Lacon has been in partnership with the Alliance for several years. The newsfeed Sol today featured a statement by Jupiter Rochester, the CEO of Core Dynamics. Lacon Spaceways has made a name for itself with its practical and well-respected ship designs, the workhorses of the galaxy. Core Dynamics can help the company reach greater heights and be even more successful. This can only be a positive move for both corporations. As with our acquisition of Vodal last year, Lacon will retain its talented engineers and production facilities while operating under our guidance. There has been no response yet from the board of directors at Lacon Spaceways. Some industry specialists have speculated that the company may have financial difficulties after investing heavily in the Alliance Chieftain and its sister ships. Questions have been raised in the Alliance Assembly about the legality of inter-superpower corporate mergers. However, neither the Federal Commerce Authority nor the Independent Commission for Market Equality have disapproved of the proposal. Commodity prices affected by market volatility. Pilots Federation alert. Volatile trading markets have caused widespread price changes on several commodities, with a focus on the mining sector. Alongside general market instability, unprecedented stock levels for a range of mined materials, such as painite, once the gold standard of many systems, mean they now have uncertain futures. Many financial experts predicted this correction to the markets, and saw it as an inevitable change. Others see this as a direct result of escalating tensions between the Empire and the Federation, with a few dismissing it as a minor anomaly and that prices will rapidly return to normal. Professor Ophelia Kaufman, head of economics at Orion Independent University, observed, "There is certainly historical precedent for volatile markets during periods of political instability. Whatever the real cause or outlook in the short term, commodity values have become far more susceptible to market forces. This is a notoriously difficult field in which to make predictions, but it is likely that prices for some lower value goods may increase. The only certainty is of further fluctuations, but their severity will largely depend on how the precarious situation between superpowers is resolved."
surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete.